Keep it up with Holmes Innovations. Keep it up with Holmes Innovations. Keep it up with Holmes Innovations. Keep it up with Holmes Innovations.
Stay tuned. Hey, Friday, come get the news. Miss Handy keeping you in tune. Aye. About what's going on in school. Homes Elementary, we going up. Knowledge is power, can't get enough. Once the beat drop, then you know it's us. Go ahead, Miss Henny, let them know what's up.
Yeah, yeah. Keep it up with Homes Innovations. Keep it up with Homes Innovations. Keep it up with Homes Innovations. Keep it up with Homes Innovations.
Hello, and welcome to Town Hall News with Miss Handy. Let's get started with our star chant. At the Holmes Innovation School, I reach for the stars. I am a scholar. What does that mean? I meet the high expectations for academic excellence. I am tenacious. What does that mean? I persevere through all my challenges on my path to excellence. I am an advocate. What does that mean? I speak up for myself and take responsibility for my learning. I am respectful. What does that mean? I value myself and my relationship with others. I fight for social justice. What does that mean? I work for equality and fairness in my community. At the Holmes Innovation School, we are all stars.
Now let's get into our announcements. The Box Program with Mr. King is happening every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday from 8:30 a.m. till 9:10 a.m. It's a great way to get your day started and getting your mind and your body ready for school. Coming soon, we will be having whole class fitness challenges. The challenges will take place Monday through Friday, and we will get back to you on the exact details. But this wellness challenge is being facilitated by the Holmes Wellness Committee. We want to get the Holmes healthy and ready. Twin Day is happening today. Make sure to send the pictures of you and your friends, or you and your teacher, to holmestownhallnews@gmail.com, and I will put them on Town Hall. Another reminder, April 2nd, there will be no school because it is Good Friday. The mail sites throughout BPS will be giving out free bags of groceries. Visit the mail sites for more information or to receive your groceries. Caring for your Chromebook. Chromebooks need to come to school each day with students, and they will return home with them at night. Here are ways to keep your Chromebook safe. Find something to wrap your Chromebook before placing it in your backpack. You can use a plastic bag, an old pillowcase, or bubble wrap. Lunch and snacks. Please do not put loose food or drink in your backpack with your Chromebook. Use a plastic bag to hold your lunch and snacks. Students should be using a BPS Chromebook that is assigned to them. We will be labeling computers as students return to help with this. Please do not peel off the labels. If you are a family with multiple BPS students and need help identifying your Chromebook, please reach out to us. You can call us at 617-635-8681, or you can email us at holmestownhallnews@gmail.com. Well, that's it for our announcements today.
Hi, My name is Brandy Fluker Oakley, and I'm state representative for the 12th Suffolk District, which covers parts of Mattapan, Dorchester, Hyde Park, and Milton. I am so excited to share with you all what it means to me to refuse to be silenced. It means always speaking up and speaking your truth, even when others might want you not to. It means not being afraid to do the right thing and advocate on behalf of others, standing up for those who might not be able to stand up for themselves. It means not being afraid to share your idea, never being afraid that what you're going to say is silly or stupid or dumb, but recognizing that you are brilliant, you are a wonderful queen, and everything that is inside of you is meant for greatness. That's what it means to me to refuse to be silenced. Even now, while you are still in elementary school and pursuing your dreams and goals, you can make a difference in your community. I organized my first protest in the third grade because I looked around and saw a policy that just wasn't fair, and I did something about it. The same is true for you. Maybe you look around your community and you see there are so many people who have been impacted by homelessness, and so you think of ways to provide food for them. Maybe you ask your family member or guardian if you can volunteer to clean up, to serve food, to read to others, to be a pen pal with maybe a senior citizen who lives on your block or in your building, somewhere in your neighborhood. There are so many things that you can do in order to serve your community now. Too often, people try to do the big things, not realizing anyone who's ever done anything big in their life, it started with a whole bunch of small things, little things, things people didn't even think to notice. That's how real change happens. It's the little things day by day and step by step. So if you're looking to make a difference in your community, find ways to volunteer. Maybe you are an older student at your school and maybe you want to read to some of the kindergartners in your school building. There are so many ways that you can give back to your community even now in order to make a difference. I would just encourage all of the young ladies who are watching this video that if you want to pursue your dreams, never ever give up and never doubt yourself. There will be people out there who might not think you can do it. I have had so many people count me out for whatever reasons. That's their problem, not yours. You know what you want to do. You know what you're destined to do. So find out what it takes to make it happen. Get a plan and take it step by step. And please know, every single one of us makes mistakes every single day, even Principal Brewster. And it's not about not making mistakes. It's about what can you do in order to pick yourself up, learn from that mistake, and do better the next time. So while you're out there pursuing your dreams and trying to achieve your best life and be your best self, I want you to know you're gonna make mistakes, and that's okay. Learning from them and trying again is what's most important. Thank you so much for having me. I wish you young queens nothing but the best.
Hello, everyone. It is Counselor at Large, Julia Mejia. Really happy to be here with you today. Happy International Women's Month to you all, beautiful young ladies. So I guess one of the questions that I need to talk to you a little bit about is, when I think about the theme, refusing to be silenced, what does that mean to me? So for me, I think about how important it is for me to speak up even when my voice quivers. I worry that sometimes, for me specifically as an Afro-Latina, as the first person in my family to graduate high school and college, winning my election by one vote on the city council and serving as an at-large counselor could be sometimes a little bit intimidating. But to me, when I think about refusing to be silent, it's really about how do I utilize my voice and how do I speak up even when my voice quivers when I have to fight for the things that I deeply care about. So when I think about refusing to be silent, I think about how important it is for all of us to speak truth to power, even when we're afraid to do so. Because there's no silencing us now. Okay. The other question that I'm asked is to give you a little bit of advice on how you can accomplish your dreams. I always say to dive into your dreams without fear, right? If you are living your purpose and you're utilizing the gifts that you have to share with others, it will never feel like you worked a day in your life. So I think that your purpose and your dreams should always be aligned. Because when we do what we love, it never feels like we're working. So I think it's really important for us to never allow ourselves to get discouraged. More importantly, you might come across a few people who say that you may not be able to do something. And what you need to remind yourself is that you could do whatever your heart sets out to do, okay? And so don't let anyone ever trample on your dreams, because you got this, okay? And you better go out and chase those dreams, because they're yours to fulfill. The last thing I need to talk to you all about is how can you make a mark on the communities even now, like you've done or are doing? So how can young ladies make a mark on their communities? Well, obviously, even if you step outside your door and knock on your neighbor's door and ask them to help you pick up the trash that is left on the sidewalk, you can organize with your friends if you want to change something in the curriculum. There's so many different ways for you to make a difference. Like sometimes you can even use TikTok. My daughter and I are on TikTok. We do little dances to just get people up and moving and to help people deal with their social, emotional, and mental well-being, right? There's so many different things that you all can do to contribute to supporting other people. So whatever it is that you do, make sure that you do it with love, okay? And I'm just so incredibly grateful for the opportunity to say hello to you all. Again, my name is Julia Mejia. I'm an at-large city councilor in the city of Boston, and I won by one vote. And so I just want you all to remember to be persistent, to be determined, and to always be grounded in your truth. Okay? Happy Women's International Month, and I guess I will see you when it's safe to do so. Until then, be true to you. Bye.
It's time for Name That History Fact with your host, Ms. Handy.
It's time for Name That History Fact, and I'm your host, Ms. Handy. Last week, I asked, what are three experiments or inventions by the Irish physicist John Tyndall? There are many answers to this question. And the winner for this week, Wanda Hall, named three, which is diamagnetics, radiation, and the greenhouse effect. Congratulations, Ms. Hall, and thank you for participating. This week, we do not have a question because next week will be Good Friday, and there'll be no school, which means no town hall. But make sure you keep tuning in to hear more history fact questions. It is now time to announce our shooting stars for the week. Jashawn in 302 is earning a star for scholarship, and he earned the top score on the math interim 2. Jaleesa in 302 is earning a star for scholarship for showing growth in the math interim 2. Alice in 302 is earning a star for scholarship for showing growth in the math interim 2. David in 302 is earning a star for scholarship for showing growth in the math interim 2. Caden in 302 is earning a star for completing 100% work on Seesaw. Zanaya in 302 is earning a star for completing 100% work on Seesaw. Judd Wondell and 302 is earning a star for completing 100% work on Seesaw. DeAndre and 205 is earning a star for working hard and in reading and writing. Carl C. and 205 is earning a star for being independent and working in class. Daniel and K1 is getting a star for being ready every day for learning. Bella and K1 is earning a star for being a kind friend. Delvin in 106 is earning a star for showing leadership and scholarship. Dominic in 106 is earning a star for scholarship and engagement. Kaylin in 106 is earning a star for tenacity and scholarship. Jacoby in 308 is earning a star for tenacity and his schoolwork. Go little J. Isaiah in 307 is earning a star for exceeding expectations in the close reading. Alana in 307 is earning a star for exceeding expectations in close reading. Jamari in 307 is earning a star for exceeding expectations in close reading. Armani in 307 is earning a star for exceeding expectations in close reading. Anthony in 307 is earning a star for meeting expectations in close reading. Devana in 307 is earning a star for meeting expectations in close reading. Brandon in 307 is earning a star for meeting expectations in close reading. Dewan in 307 is earning a star for meeting expectations in close reading. Jaden in 307 is earning a star for meeting expectations in close reading. Alana in 307 is earning a star for scholarship. Jose in 307 is earning a star for scholarship. Brandon in 307 is earning a star for scholarship. And Michaela in 307 is earning a star for scholarship. Tarek in 307, earning a star for scholarship and getting a level green on close reading. Camilla is earning a star for tenacity, working hard in math. Danny in 302 is earning a star for social justice, helping partners in guided reading. Ambassador in 303 is earning a star for being tenacious and going above and beyond expectations. Brooklyn in 202 is earning a star for being scholarly in phonics. Derek in 201, earning a star for being scholarly in phonics. Miguel in 202, earning a star for being scholarly in phonics. Jed Wondell in 203 is earning a star for being scholarly in phonics. Brianna in 202, earning a star for being scholarly in phonics. Jashawn in 202, earning a star for being scholarly in phonics. Germani in 303, earning a star for being tenacious and determined. Justin in 303, earning a star for being an advocate and always willing to help. That's it for our shooting stars this week. On the count of three, let's give them all a shooting star. One, two, three. Shooting star. Congratulations, scholars, and keep up the terrific work.
This week's star teacher is someone who supports students across many different grades. They find ways to connect with students, so much so that many former students will often look for them or reach out to connect with them. And we all know how important relationships are to us at the homes. They want to make sure students are pushed and held to high standards. This week's star teacher is none other than Mr. DePina. Thank you, Mr. DePina, for all you do.
It is now time for my favorite part of town hall, the dance out. This week, we'll be dancing to Run the World by the Queen, Beyoncé. Girls, we run this.
Me.